hold a new round of trade talks, that is. Washington's offer of talks comes as the White House prepares to impose more tariffs on $200 billion worth of Chinese imports. Meanwhile, a survey shows that American companies in China are being hurt by tariffs and the growing trade war between Washington and Beijing. Now, that has prompted American business lobbies behind the poll to urge the administration of President Donald Trump to reconsider its approach. In the meantime, the U.S. Federal Reserve warns that American businesses have scaled back or have postponed investments due to concerns about international trade tensions. Stavros Mavridis, professor of political economy at the University of Macedonia, joins us from Athens. Hello and welcome. So we have another Trump/U.S. move towards China. They want to talk now. I'm not guessing China is feeling really good based on the additional tariffs that might be imposed, which would then round up or equal to the sum of $500 billion. How do you see this U.S. move?
Well, there is a strategic and a tactical dimension in this ongoing tug of war between U.S. and China, and not only. The strategic dimension is that the U.S. Trump administration considers China its main opponent, its main challenger for world supremacy, and so sees the U.S. administration aims to shorten China. Trade war and protectionist measures are a weapon, an economic weapon, in this strategic aim. Now, the tactical dimension is that neither U.S. Nor China are inclined, at least currently, towards an all-out war, economic war. For this reason, there is a tit-for-tat within a tug of war. The U.S. imposed tariffs, then China retaliated, then a new wave of tariffs, and then a round of renegotiation. Keep in mind that there was a round before in Geneva that was produced no outcome. Now, almost 2 weeks since then, or less than 2 weeks, the Trump administration, the initiator of this trade war, asked for new talks. So the whole picture is very fuzzy if you see only the tactical moves. If you focus on the strategic dimension, it's pretty clear. The U.S. Aims to shorten China. On the other hand, China knows this very well, but it is not, at least currently, determined for an all-out war. If it were, the first and the possibly the most strongest blow would be a sell-off of American debt held at public debt, American public debt held in Chinese hands, which would have disastrous consequences for the U.S. economy. This has not happened yet. So we are in a situation where the strategic differences are pretty clear, but there are a lot of tactical moves from the one on the other side.
Okay, thank you so much for that. Stavros Mavridis, professor of political economy at the University of Macedonia.